Okay, because I had the U13 before, so let's start. I think we have everyone, hopefully. Okay. So thank you for joining, guys. I know it's a long day, and now you have to be with the boring French coach that is crazy. So hopefully I will it will be worth your time. Can you see my screen, guys?
Yes.
Yes, coach.
Okay. So let's go. Agenda. As I mentioned to some of you guys, we will try to go with the 4-3-2-1. We can adapt it, okay? Of course, we can always adapt 4-3-2-1 to 4-2-3-1, okay? But at this one, one of the scenarios is the 4-3-2-1 because I think you have the strength. And for what I saw with the games, the online games on the VO and on the training session, I think that that can work against the U13 Friday. And yeah, I will show you some football video that I selected, the one from Mbappe. I told you yesterday to check in, check out. I just want to show you this one, some housekeeping stuff, some video that I took, and of course, talk about tactic. On the right side, I just took this video that from Cristiano Ronaldo, because we always talk about motivation. You know, your coach has to motivate you, your teammates has to motivate you, your parents, they have to motivate you, but it comes from you first, okay? It comes from you first with auto motivation. And Cristiano Ronaldo is one of the, I will say, professional player that talks a lot about it, do a lot about it, that every time before a free kick, before a game, before a penalty, he's talking to himself. That is the best, that you will make it, that you will do it no matter what. So it starts from you that, you know, even though it doesn't work, be focused on the next wave. Be a goldfish for those that follow Ted Lasso like me. Just think about the next one. Don't. The body language is not like, oh, I missed a penalty. Oh, I missed a pass. Oh, I missed the life is done. You know, football game is done for me. I will play curling or whatever. It just focus on the next one. Thank you, assistant. My assistant, Dali. So that's just a quick video that I wanted to show you about it. This is important too, guys. We always talk about the feedback. You know, I will be more focused on this with you sometimes, asking you after a session or a game, some feedback. You know, what did you think about your game? What did you think you could improve? What did you do well? What do you think you want to stop doing, this type of stuff? And even on alone, you know, I just talk about the self motivation, the same for you. Just think before a session or after a session again, talk to yourself in, I will say, and be like, you know what, today I want to improve this. At the end of the session, you know what, I think I did well today, 7 on 10. This could be improved, but I had a long day. I was a little bit tired today, so I will try to be better for the next session or the next game. That's the same I'm doing, guys. I record every session, every game, not just for you guys, but for me. Like yesterday, I finished the session and I was like, you know what, this, maybe I can improve it. This training game, maybe next time, you know what, I make it bigger, maybe smaller, maybe instead of having this, I will do this. Maybe when I talk to Julian, for example, I should say this and not that. So it's, you know, an improvement. Nobody is perfect. I always told you since day one, the first one that will do a mistake is me. So just continue. But on your side, that's good if you can talk about it, if you can talk to yourself and try to improve. And sometimes when you do an auto-evaluation, that's the moment that you're like, you know what, I know what to do next next time. We will work, of course, on throwing. That's something that I told you yesterday. We lose a lot of ball. I saw on the games online that every throw-in, one or two, 50% they are lost. Directly goes to the team, to the opponent. So that's something that just working on the check-in, check-out, you know, don't come too early to ask the ball. Ask the ball with eye contact, with the hand, be vocal, body language. So that's few tips that can help you to keep the ball. Set pieces. We will work on 2-3 scenarios when we have an offensive or defensive set pieces, what we do. Discipline. Continue to be disciplined. It works really well. Every session I do with you guys, you are always focused from the beginning to the end. So that's really, I feel really, really happy with it. You know, it's always a pleasure when I come and I'm like, okay, you know what, for 90 minutes, even more, I know that everybody will have a full focus and will want to move forward and improve. Two key points, guys. Don't be attracted just by the ball. Sometimes I see, and I saw it yesterday, I gave a tip. Remember when I asked you to stop and one of you guys came inside instead of just stretching the line on the right side. I don't remember who was it. I think it was maybe Matteo or Mark. I don't remember. But that's the thing I'm saying with it. Don't be attracted by just the ball. That's the thing. If you see your teammate is on the ball, don't come next to him. I know you like him, he's a good friend, but just create space for him and for you, okay? Man marking in defense will go simple. Instead of being defending in the zone, I will be like, you know what? John, you take this player, take the number 6. I take the number 7, for example, Matteo. Okay, we're good. You know, we keep it simple at the beginning. Screen behind you, guys. Make sure that when I ask to cut a passing line, your opponent is behind you, so he can't receive the ball because they will try to find the pocket of space, something that I'm always telling you. I don't want to go too in-depth tonight with a tactical board online. This I will do it later on in the upcoming session. Monday, I will bring the tactical board and I will show it to you on the board and on the field because tonight you already too many times too much on the screen. I don't want to keep you for extra 10 minutes and show you a tactical board online. We'll do it Monday. It's better. When we have time, sometimes we rush. When we don't have time, sometimes we are slow. We just have to know, to know, like I mentioned to Noah at the end of the session yesterday, sometimes we have to know when we play in one, two touches, and sometimes we have to know when we have time and we can play in 5, 6 touches. For example, if our team is not didn't reset in the 4-4-2 or 4-3-2-1, whatever. That's the moment, especially from the defensive side or from Luke or Luca, to keep the ball, make sure your team reset from the side, they stretch the line, whatever, and we play, okay? Play close when the danger is far, play far when the danger is close, okay? That's something that you will hear me during the year. I'm always telling you to, can you see the ball? Can the ball seize you? If the answer is no, it's that you have to move and try to find the pocket of space. Another motto that I always mention, play for the team and the team will play for you. Important. If you try to play alone, guys, I will see it. And it will not work for me. It will not work for you. It will not work for the team and the result. Because in U14, guys, by the way, this year, the two top team, they go in final. It's not like U13. We just check the result. There is no standing. In U14, it's starting to go with the top two team. I think Jimmy can maybe correct me. But I talked to Maricel from the club, and she told me that in U14, the two top team, I think they go in final or they go with in a tournament, something like this. So I know some of you already told me that you want to go high in standings and whatever. That's good. But let's see what we can do, okay? It's not just saying, hey, we want to go high. We want to be top 3 tonight, this year, okay? But what you will do, guys, to achieve this, okay? It's not just saying this and it will come. No, you have to work. If you want to have everything, you need to be ready to give everything, okay? It's not just, hey, today, long ball on West and Wisco and that's it. No, no, you need more, okay? It's a teamwork. 4-3-2-1. Okay, let's talk a little bit more. I took some pictures so you have a little bit more of an idea, not just like me talking and you behind the screen. So, the 4-3-2-1. I think in the past you played this type of tactic. No, I think I saw 4-2-3-1. Correct me if I'm wrong. Did you play already 4-3-2-1 or it was more the 4-2-3-1 that you played?
It was more the 4-2-3-1.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so you're already used to because the difference between 4-3-2-1 and 4-2-3-1, it's not a big one, guys. Okay. So that's good that you already play with it. But I just took some pictures. So that's the PSG in the past when they were still Messi, Neymar, and Mbappé. So you could see like in the middle they had the two players. So it was 4-3-2 and Mbappé was on top sleeping. Sometimes on the right side, so you know it, guys. The 4-2-3-1. You see that I'm already on you guys, especially the left and full and right back to stretch the line. When we have the ball, I really want you to be stretching the line and take the throwing line as a reference for you to stretch the line. I really want you, every time we build from the back or we are in possession of the ball, make the field big. Remember, I always tell you, when we have the ball, make the field big. When we don't have the ball, we are like angry dogs and we want to take the ball as soon as possible. But here, the fullbacks, they are really stretching the line. Okay, they are not inside in the, on the same line in the half space with the 6, 7, and 4. They are really stretching the line. Here, it's more a picture of the different position name and the advantage and disadvantage of the 4-3-2-1. This we will talk more and more during the upcoming session on the field. I will bring the tactical board, the online session, and we will adapt it during a game. Okay, so nothing new for you because you already play 4-2-3-1. But I just want to take a quick video of 3 minutes that I found on internet. By the way, do you know a coach, a famous coach that play this 4-3-2-1? Do you know a coach, professional coach? I will give you a tip. They played this week in Champions League and they were losing, but they won at the end.
Real Madrid?
Yeah. Carlo Ancelotti plays, especially when he was at the PSG, he was playing this 4-3-2-1. And at Real Madrid, he was playing the 4-3-2-1 when he was with Benzema, Cristiano Ronaldo. Okay? So it's not that we are at the level of Real Madrid yet, but just...
What better way to bring in the Christmas season than by analyzing football's most festive formation, the 4-3-2-1. Also known as the Christmas tree. It's one of the many variants of a popular five-man midfield system like 4-2-3-1 or 4-3-3, though it is quite unconventional. With three central midfielders who protect the back four, two attacking midfielders are given complete freedom to roam ahead of them. The deployment of two creative players goes against the consensus that they cannot work cohesively in most systems. Steven Gerrard and Frank Lampard for England being a notable example. A lack of natural width is perhaps the most obvious issue for the Christmas tree formation. With essentially five midfielders who operate in central areas, the fullbacks are expected to provide almost all the team's width. Fullbacks need to possess the engines to get up and down the flanks for the whole 90 minutes. Moving up the pitch, the lone striker can easily be isolated from the rest of his side and needs strength, a sound first touch, and good decision-making to be able to link up with the supporting midfielders. However, with the right players, the system has proven to be devastating. France at the 1998 World Cup, a tournament they would go on to win, started out by lining up in the Christmas tree.
Of course.
Yuri Djorkaeff and Zinedine Zidane, with his supreme skills,
Zidane, guys,
had complete freedom to roam, but were only afforded this luxury due to the immense wall they had behind them. In Didier Deschamps, Emmanuel Petit and Christian Carambeau, France had three central midfielders whose primary duty was to hold down the center of the park and defend. While that could suggest a degree of rigidity was key to the system's overall function, it was in fact the fluidity of the system and players involved that propelled France to World Cup glory. Manager Aimé Jacquet gave almost all his players the option to roam forward, starting with the fullbacks, who provided crucial width in the system. Overall, it was a predominantly defensive system, with France conceding just 2 goals in 7 games. Jacquet needed a system that could release the attacking artistry of Zinedine Zidane without feeling the effects of his defensive ineptitude, and he got that with the 4-3-2-1. Another fantastic exponent of the Christmas tree was AC Milan under Carlo Ancelotti. The Rossoneri lifted their 7th UEFA Champions League trophy using the system. Starting at the back, Milan were blessed with Paolo Maldini and Alessandro Nesta in front of Brazilian goalkeeper Dida. They had the most enviable of insurance policies, giving fullbacks Cafu and Marek Jankulovski license to bomb up and down the flanks. In midfield, the shuttling of Massimo Ambrosini, an intelligent, defensively sound player, and Gennaro Gattuso, a fearsome ball-winning midfielder, set the stage for Andrea Pirlo. With both of them either side of him, Pirlo had less of a defensive burden and could focus on linking the midfield to the attack with his stunning range of passing. Ahead of them were Clarence Seedorf and Kaká, who were expected to provide width, support the striker, and get into the box to finish off moves. Filippo Pippo Inzaghi led the line as a lone striker, often criticised for his lack of technical skills, but was an incredible goal poacher. Again, fluidity was pivotal to the success of the 4-3-2-1 under Carlo Ancelotti. Overall, it's seldom to see a 4-3-2-1 used in modern football. The 4-3-3 and 4-2-3-1 are the more commonly used five-man midfield formations.
So that is why 4-3-2-1, it's not like, oh, coach, we'll just play this with me. You will see later on when I will show you some slide that I did on my game model. Because, you know, there are coaches, they're like, oh, we play my way, or that's it. With me, it's more like a chameleon. At this one, I'm still like learning from you guys, your strengths and weaknesses or the points to improve. And we're like, you know what? Let's play this tactic today because I think you have the strength to do it. And because the opposition may be in the midfielder, they are not good. You know, maybe if the opposition, they are like just 11 Godzilla, we'll play maybe a 4-4-2 and we will just wait them and we will counterattack them. It's just that we have to manage expectation and the profile that you have, guys. So I'm still learning from you, but for what I saw on the videos and on the field, and next Friday against the U14, that will be a perfect scenario. We can adapt, okay? You already work on this tactic. I saw that you work on 4-3-3 sometimes too, so that's good. You already have some knowledge. Let's go a little bit further now, and with the online session and with your feedback, let's see what we can do. Okay, let's continue. I'm almost done. Okay, so after that's some ideas, guys. Hey, you see, that's for you, Godzilla on the right side. You happy, John? John,
yes, coach.
Are you happy?
Yes, coach.
Okay, perfect. That's for you, my friend. Okay, so we need you to eliminate the opponent like this, but yeah, a little bit more like, serious, that's the idea, guys. Okay, when I talk at the beginning about the 4-2-3-1, I wanted to add it too. So if your name is not here, guys, don't worry. I'm just working on different names, different scenario for Friday. So Friday after 20 minutes, we will switch. We will be like, you know what, John, let's try as center back. Garrett, let's try as right back. Go in the middle after. I just want to see the different position and strength where you can be. Because for me, guys, you can't just play one position. It doesn't work. You can't be like, coach, I'm the superstar. I just play this position. That's it. No, 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 no. You have to play 2-3 position. Because first, you need it. Okay? Secondly, what happens if one day, I don't know, somebody is injured, red card, sick, whatever, and we have to adapt. We can't be like, oh, we can't play. Oh, but we play 10 against 11. You know what? So that is why I just put some ideas here, guys. So... by Friday, I will bring more ideas, more names, and more position ideas for you. But just to give you an example here that I took during these few days with like different position, yeah, exactly. Okay, so the names, they are more or less the same, but you will see by Friday. I will come with maybe four tactics because I don't know the game if we do 80 minutes. And we divided like in OPDL by 20 minutes. It can be good, I think. So we can every 20 minutes we can switch the tactic, and we can switch and we can try players to different position. Sounds good, guys?
Yes, coach.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some video. That's the one from Mbappe, guys, during the World Cup with his defender. It's a really fast check-in, check-out, but I wanted to show you. Okay. After he was pretty fast, now he's a little bit sleepy, but that's the check-in, check-out. Make it uncomfortable, okay? That's what we want with the opponent. So throw-in, for example, when you do a throw-in, guys, don't come too early towards the ball. Two videos that I took on Instagram, guys. Every week I will select a few videos from Instagram. It can be more related to the defenders, more related maybe for the strikers. But I just wanted to show you this video that I think is important because I saw it the last training session, that sometimes you engage, you overcommit. So I just wanted to show you this video. Let me just share my screen. So it's the same video that I showed to the U13 because it was the same. Okay, here we go.
Too fast, big steps, no control. You'll easily get beat. Instead, approach fast or put on the brakes a few yards away and then get side on, taking small steps to maintain balance. Do this when pressing and you'll stand a bigger chance of winning the ball back or forcing your opponent into a mistake. If you're looking for a way to improve your game intelligence, then
I will pull it one again.
Too fast, big steps, no control. You'll easily get beat. Instead, approach fast or put on the brakes a few yards away and then get side on, taking small steps to maintain balance.
Don't overcommit and let the opponent do his trick or let him do a back pass coming back to his goalkeeper or defender. That's what we want. If there is no danger, it doesn't make sense to overcommit. Let them do the tiki-taka in the back. That's perfect. They are not dangerous for us. Okay? So small step, light on your toes. That's really key for everyone. That you are defenders, strikers, midfielder is the same. You will go 1v1 at one point, so you have to make sure that you're ready for this. Let me finish. Okay, there is a bug now. Let me see why it's getting slower now. Okay, now it's getting slow. Give me a second. What is going on? Too many windows open with football. That's not good. Okay, quickly. Did some of you in the same time watch some games today or no?
Yes.
What did you watch?
I watched Juve versus, or the highlights of Juve versus someone in the Champions League.
Okay. It was good?
Yeah. They played bad, Juve.
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah. I saw it. It's okay. They have a really good coach. I really love Thiago Motta. So, where I was. Okay, you can see my screen. A few tips, guys. Because at your age, I saw it. Especially, I saw it against Ottawa. When you play Ottawa, you had this striker that was really fast and physical. So, few tips when you have to defend against a tall and fast player. Okay, remember arm distance to defend. Okay, don't be too close to an opponent. Don't be too far. Okay, after you have to adapt. If in front of you the striker is a player that go really fast, you don't, and it's really skill wise is really good. You don't want to be too far from him, because if he has the time to turn, he can beat you easily in 1v1 or with the pace. So you really have to make sure that you are really tight to him to make it uncomfortable. Like I always mention, remember the 3-point, guys, keep it simple, communication, and make it uncomfortable for your opponent. So you make sure that when you receive the ball, you're breathing in his neck and he's under the stress. Okay? The other point, like a few points that they look like normal, easy to understand, but it's always a good reminder, guys, for you to have before you enter the field, especially when you play this type of player against Ottawa that you will have again this season. Effective communication and teamwork, it's really important, guys, okay? Because if you are beat, but you are still working as a team and compact, the other teammates, for example, if you are the left back and you are eliminated by the opponent, your left center back can come and cover you and try to take back the ball. Okay? That's really important. The communication, teamwork, read the game. Remember yesterday I stopped you during the session because David was the left foot and he was just cutting inside, because our body language was on the outside. We were just inviting him to cut inside instead of telling him, hey, my friend, just go follow the line. You will see with the right foot if it's the same. Okay? So just a few points for the defensive players. And next week, it will be maybe points more focused for the offensive player. Reminder, guys. Sorry for the picture. Let me just put it on the left because my friend Zlatan Ibrahimovic is on the right. Few points, how to receive the ball. Remember, for the throw-in, eye contact, hands where you want it with your hands on my left foot if you left foot it, on the right foot, chest, header maybe, so the other player, your other teammates can follow the ball through behind you, body shape, and the voice. Really important. On the right side, this video, it's a really nice interview. I love this guy, Zlatan, that was interviewed a few months ago. You can find it on YouTube. And he was saying that his mentality is that he can beat anyone, everyone. Even if it's like a Tyson Fury, he's like, if I'm in front of Tyson Fury, of course, I know he will beat me because he's a world champion. But in my head, I will be, you know what? I will beat you. And that's the mentality that you need, guys, when you enter the field. I'm not saying that you will have to punch the other player, but back to the first line with Cristiano Ronaldo, the right mentality comes from you directly, okay? Me, I will try my best, guys, to support you on and off the field, but it has to come from you directly, okay? You have to feel confident. If you want everything, you have to be ready to give everything, okay? It's not like easy, like, hey, today, easy, peasy, 3 points, we don't want to run. We just kick the ball really far. And maybe on one occasion, we will score. No, it will not happen. It will maybe happen one time. But on the other 12 or 13 games, guys, if you have this mentality of just doing the minimum, doesn't work. Okay? Team Snap, as usual, it's perfect. Most of you always pull it 24 hours before a session. So that's perfect for me to prepare the training session accordingly to how many players we have. We have some tryout still next week. Hopefully, it's more or less the end coming slowly but surely so we can really work on the tactical aspect. And as usual, one of my motto, guys, work before progress. It's really important, this. Okay? If you want to see progress, you have to work. You have to do the work on the field, off the field. I saw Luke yesterday staying 10 minutes after the end of the session, doing some push-ups, some work on the abs and everything. That's the work, guys. That's the dedication that we need if you want to go far in football and even in your life, guys. Okay? Some tips, okay? 10 things that require zero talent. Being on time, making an effort, being high energy. Some of you will have a long day. You had like a bad mark. I don't know. You had a discussion with your parent. You're a little bit exhausted. When you come, guys, you forget everything. Football should be 90 minutes, 100 minutes of pure enjoyment and thinking about just the soccer ball and nothing else. Have a positive attitude. Be passionate. That's what I am, guys, and hopefully everyone is passionate about football. Good body language with you, with your teammates, no matter what happened. Being coachable, that's a luxury that I have with you guys. That's a pleasure every week to be on the field. I'm always waiting for this time to be on the field to coach you guys. Do a little extra, like I just mentioned with the example from Luke. Being prepared, no matter what happened, guys. Good thing or bad things, and having a strong work ethic, okay? The other stuff, guys, you can read it, you adults, so I let you read, and I will finish with my favorite show. Let me know if there is sound, guys, okay?
Okay, no sound.
No sound again. Let me see. If I do this, if I do that, let me go to download. If I do that, let me see if there is sound now. If I open directly. There is sound?
No
code.
No.
My God. Why? Why they don't let me put the sound of this? I don't understand.
Coach, you can just turn on the captions and we'll read it.
There is no caption this time, my friend. That's the thing. Let me just... Did some of you watch, by the way, Ted Lasso? Just to know.
Yeah, I watched some.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So you know when I'm saying be a goldfish, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. You know, I know how to show it. I'm a little bit stupid sometimes, but it's directly on YouTube. I don't know why I didn't do this before. Okay. For those that didn't watch Ted Lasso, guys, it's one of the best show for me. There is good thing to take, and that's one of them. So let me just show it to you. Here we go. Here we go. Now there is sound.
So we'll get some flowers, because this spot here is where Sam died. It's very sad.
Oi, walk away, you little prick.
All right, Grandad, keep your wig on.
Thanks, Roy.
Yeah, you're good.
Hey, Sam, come here a sec.
Coach, I'm sorry.
You know what the happiest animal on Earth is? It's a goldfish. You know why?
No.
Got a 10-second memory. Be a goldfish, Sam. Yeah? Yeah, you got it. Go ahead.
Okay, for those that watch Ted Lasso or even the other one, why do you think he's saying be a goldfish, guys?
So if you make a mistake, like, then you forget about it.
Yeah, exactly, guys.
Like, move on, even if you make, like, mistake.
Stay positive.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, Mark, exactly. Just move on, guys. You know, there is no mistake in any case. If you say you do a mistake, it's because you try something. I'm always tell you, try something. I'm good with it. As long as after you recover and you manage it, I'm good. But football, you have to try stuff. And if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. That's it. We try next one, okay? That is why he's saying be a goldfish. Just move on. Think about the next one. Like surfer, it's the same. The surfer, when they miss a wave, they are just focusing on the next one and the next one and the next one. It's the same, okay? So just keep it like this. I saw a really good body language yesterday. You were just focused on the next one. You were positive with your teammates, and that's what we need, guys. If you want to go far away, we need it. And to finish, one of my favorite players, because I'm a hangry dog on the field when I play at 100%, is Roy Keane. If you don't know him, when he finished this session, guys, go on YouTube, put Roy Keane, okay? But what he was saying, one of his motto was, if you're not prepared to run, don't play the game. Okay, especially now, the modern game, where we ask, you just saw it, the fullback to go up and down. It's not just the fullback. Everybody, I will ask them to run a lot, because you need it, guys. Football, it's first, it's about foot, so it's about running. You need that everybody's on the same page. We are doing work with Coach Terry that is doing some strengthness at the beginning of the session. We'll do more and more of this at the beginning of January. So just to make sure that you're ready to play. My exercise, it's high intensity. Some of them I don't go and I don't tell you to take water. It's because I want you to keep the high intensity. That's the reason why, guys. We need this because we will have friendly games, we'll have tournament, but it's not the same as having like a games every week. And this will not come before April, May. Okay? So we have to find the solution. We have to find a plan B. And that's the reason why it has to be high intensity, everything we do, okay? That's it on my side, guys. Any question, tips? I'm still thinking about the captain, guys. I have some names I'm trying because I receive, like, I think 8, 9 candidates. That's perfect. I love it, guys. But I will have to make a choice like I did a few weeks ago with some players that I had to release. So in any case, no matter what happened, guys, like I said, for the U13 that selected the vice captain and the captains, we have them. That you are captain or not chosen to be a captain, guys, show by example, lead by example, guys. Huh? It's not that you are captain that the other they have to hide. And it's not like that you are the captain that now everything is on you. And you have to be like the president and whatever, guys. No, no, no. You keep it. You keep it the way that I found you, guys. Just show, lead by example on and off the field, and make sure that the team is on the same page. That's it, guys. No, nothing to worry. But I will select two captains, and the two captains will select the vice captains. They will select one vice captain in discussion with me. Okay. So this will come, I think, this week or next week. Maybe this week I want it before the first game. But yeah, keep you posted. I have some ideas, and let's see how it goes on and off the field starting Monday again. Okay. Question, guys? Anything for me before you go on PlayStation or whatever?
Coach, are we going to try like different formations in the games against the U13s?
Yeah, we can try. For sure, 4-3-2-1, 4-2-3-1. You saw the video I show you guys. The 4-3-2-1, it's an extension of 4-3-3 or 4-2-3-1. So I think let's keep it simple. I don't want to be every 5 minutes. Hey, 4-3-3. No, 4-3-2-1. No, let's go. But maybe for the 80 minutes game, let's do 2-2 maybe. Because you already know some of them. Let's go 2 or 3. If you are really into it, if you are really disciplined, we can try three formation. But it's all about how you move, guys. I can tell you to play 10 different tactics. It's all about the flow on the field, guys. Okay, and how the opposition play. Okay, so I will tell you. You will know the tactic they are playing. We are starting with one system with them because it's the first time they play 11 against 11. Be ready, guys, because the U13. They are really ready. Technically, they are really good. Physically, they are really good. We already in advance with the periodization. So don't take it easy, guys. I expect a lot from you and from them. So don't think it will be easy. Okay? Nothing else? Mark, the others?
No.
Eli, nobody? Luca? Mero, nobody? Godzilla?
Coach? No.
Yeah, Lucas, go.
Do we have the friendly against the U13s this week?
Yeah, November 1st, Friday.
Okay, thank you.
And Team Snap, I had it times, guys, because I observed that every session until end of November, there is nobody on the field until 10 p.m. Even the coach yesterday night, he said, oh, you can stay more. I was like, why? He said, oh, because there is nobody after you until 10. I was like, okay. So I had it time. So now we will try to finish 9:15, 9:20. We'll do almost 2 hours of training. Okay. We will enjoy the time we still have outside until end of November. Yeah. Somebody said something?
I just said thank you, coach.
Ah, okay. You can send me money if you want to. So I can buy new shirts.
Yep.
Because I have so many shirts. So, but I have to continue, you know. Okay. Good stuff, guys. Anybody else, guys? Are you already sleeping? No? Tips, feedback? In any case, this is recorded. It's always on the YouTube channels, but I don't think this one you will want to watch it again. The other one, the next one, that they are more tactical and technical, maybe. Okay, guys? See you. Have a great weekend. Enjoy. It's still not so cold. Play football. And I see you Monday on the field. Okay, Luca, take it easy. And hopefully I see you back Monday. Okay?
Yeah.
Bye, guys. Have a good night.
Bye, coach.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye. Thank you, coach.
You're welcome. Bye, guys.
Thank you, coach.